Today we're going to talk about soap dishes. I like a soap dish better than a soap bottle. I like a bar of soap better than liquid soap. You're allowed to like what you like. But I'm going to show you how to turn this little pancake into this cute little dish with all the little grooves to catch your soap schmutch. Technical pottery talk, I know. So this is about 800 grams of clay. You want your soap dish to have a bit of weight to it. And I've centered this out to be about 6 inches wide. Some people have problems centering a flat piece. If you do, you can just cut it down to the size you want. Allow the wheel to make many revolutions before your needle makes its way down. And then undercut that. And now, if you had problems centering your clay, it's centered, and this isn't wasted. I'll wedge this up at the end of the day and throw it tomorrow. So this is centered, and I'm just going to open it up and make the little grooves on the bottom and make me a little soap dish. So I'm just going to put my finger in there, and I'm going to start pulling. Now, when you go down, make sure you leave a thick bottom. You need to have a heavy bottom. Ply joke here. You want to have a heavy bottom because you have to have enough room in the bottom to put your grooves and still have some clay at the bottom of your groove. So I'm just going to open this up. I'm going to pull my fingers across. You can't see what my hands are doing. These fingers are pulling across. My thumb is protecting that because when you open up a flat piece, this wants to peel off. You don't want your soap dishes peeling. Anyway, so we're going to pull that across, and I'm just keeping all that in check. When I can get to here, I want to bring my thumb over to there, and then they're just going to work together and pull across. And when I can, I'm going to bring my thumb up this way and join all of those together. So nothing about my soap dish at this point is appealing. Hopefully later on they'll have some characteristics that are appealing. So I'm pulling across and opening it up. So I'm just going to open it up, and I want this dish to be heavy. As I said before, I like a soap dish. I use mine in the kitchen. I've got a porcelain sink. You want a dish that has some weight to it, some substance, and it just feels better when it has a bit of weight to it. Anyway, so now I've got kind of a messy bottom here. I'm going to move. I like this movement. I use this a lot on bowls, and I'm just going against. The wheel's still going the same way, but I just went opposite to the wheel, and it just leaves a nice, it just tidies up your bottom. Okay, so now as I said, the bottom is thick. I'll show you how thick my bottom is. So the bottom is thick, it's that thick, so it has a lot of weight to it. I wouldn't usually leave a bottom that thick on a bowl or a mug or anything, but I will on a soap dish. Now you can make the grooves by just putting your fingertip in there, but I like to use a stick. The stick just has a crisper line to it. And I'm just going to clean it off. So there's that question, how do you like your soap dish lines? I like my soap dish lines crisp. Anyway, so I'm gonna dig those down and make a crisp soap dish line. And I've got a little sponge here. And I'm just going to go in and tidy those up. And dry them out. I want to give this wall a bit of height and definition. I've often said before, I like it when a pot is done, it comes up and goes, I'm done. It just doesn't kind of run out of clay. So I'm just going to give this a little bit of definition here. Just kind of an edge to it. A little extra height. Get rid of all that water in there that seems to be gathering. So now my bottom is tidy but thick. And my walls have some definition. I'm going to just cut the side off of this, and I'm just going to undercut it and take quite a bit of clay off of there. So when I take this little soap dish off the wheel, it's done. So this is trimmed now. I won't put it back on the wheel to trim it. I'll tidy it up with my stick that's not here. There's the stick I wanted. The stick. Too many sticks. And tidy that up. And I want to just take a chamois and sponge it off. So there is a soap dish. It is trimmed, it is sponged, it's ready for me signing the bottom, and I'll cut it off. And that's how I make a soap dish. So if you liked watching me make the little soap dish with its tidy but thick bottom, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you. Just put them in the comment section. And thanks ever so much for watching.